Say that you'll marry me. Sometimes carry me. And I will be there forevermore for you. And if you marry me, I will give everything, and I will do anything that you need me to. You'll know by the love in my eyes and the beat of my heart, I'll be there. You'll know, 'cause you'll never be lonely again, anytime, anywhere. This I promise if you marry me. Promise you. All the whole
Sir, I'm a bit nervous about being here today. Still not real sure what I'm going to say. So bear with me please if I take up too much of your time. You see in this box is a ring for your oldest. She's my everything and all that I know is it would be such a relief if I knew that we were on the same side. Cause very soon I'm hoping that I can marry your daughter and make her my wife. I want her to be the only girl that I love for the rest of my life. And give her the best of me till the day that I die. Yeah, I'm gonna marry a princess and make her my queen. She'll be the most beautiful bride that I've ever seen. I can't wait to smile when she walks down the aisle on the arm of her father, on the day that I marry your daughter. She's been here every step since the day that we met.
I'm scared to death to think of what would happen if she ever left.
So don't you ever worry about me ever treating her bad.
Somebody who cares. When I found you, found my most intimate prayer. When I found you, I found what every heart dreams of. When I found you, I found love. When I found you, I found the rest of my life. When I found you, I told all others goodbye. When I found you, I saw my fears fly away like a dove.
We assemble here this afternoon to witness the joining of Vincent Junior Walters and Antoinette Tiffany Kelly in holy matrimony, and to wish them God's blessings and everything that is good. Everything that is good as they are about to begin their new life as husband and as wife. Studies have shown that individuals who are married and who have developed their skills to face successfully, are necessary that skills that will help them to face successfully all the challenges that may come before them, tend to live longer, happier, do better financially and raise well-rounded children. Marriage is indeed a wonderful experience, and we pray that their life together would be a satisfying and fulfilling one. And we pray that years from now, they would reflect on this occasion, not with any remorse or regrets, but with great satisfaction and fulfillment in their hearts. Let us pray. Our Father, we come calling upon your name, knowing that you are never tired of hearing from us, and knowing that you have the power and the ability to hear and to answer our prayers and to grant our requests. We pray for Vincent and Antoinette, who have come to seal this wonderful relationship which they have started more than 5 years ago in holy matrimony. God, we know that the relationship of marriage into which they are about to enter is filled with all kinds of negatives. And God, we pray that as they walk this path, they will be able to influence others to walk in their footsteps. May you hear us, and may you bless us, we pray. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen. We now have a scripture reading, which will be done by Jonathan Walker.
Our scripture reading for today is taken from 1 Corinthians 13. I'll be reading from verse 4 to 7. That's 1 Corinthians 13, reading from verse 4 to 7. It reads, "Love suffers long and is kind. Charity envieth not. Charity vaunteth not itself. It's not puffed up. Doth not behave itself unseemly, seeketh not her own. It is not easily provoked, thinketh no evil. Rejoice not in iniquity, but rejoice in truth. Beareth all things, believe all things, hopeth all things, endureth all things." Here in the reading of a portion of scripture, may I say amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
You know that marriage is a divine institution. It was ordained by God to be a blessing to humanity. God in his divine wisdom says that it is not good for a man to be alone. And so he made a helpmeet suitable for man. He didn't give man a helper, but a helpmeet, one suitable. Paul tells us in 1 Corinthians that, chapter 7, it is better for a man to marry than to burn. And I guess he's speaking about men and women. The Hebrew writer tells us in Hebrews chapter 13 that marriage is honorable in the sight of all, and the bed should be undefiled. And the whoremongers and adulterers, God will judge. And we pray that they would really live out this verse of scripture in their lives. You know that it is the dream of every woman to walk down the aisle with a handsome looking young man by their side, and we can say that Antoinette's dream is now a reality, because standing beside her is the proud and handsome looking Vincent.
Thank you, sir.
Solomon tells us that whoso finds a wife finds a good thing. We can say with certainty this afternoon that Vincent has found a wife in Antoinette.
Yes, sir.
And that's the reason why he's here this afternoon.
Amen.
To let all of us know and the rest of the world know that he has found a woman of his dream.
Yes, sir.
And if you notice that he's not sleeping enough, he's wide awake,
yes,
putting his dream into reality. And we pray that God's blessings would be upon them as they are about to begin their life's journey together as husband and as wife. Dearly beloved, we are gathered together here in the sight of God and in the face of this company to join together this man and this woman in holy matrimony, which is commended of Paul to be honorable among all men. And therefore, it is not by any to be entered into, listen carefully, unadvisedly or lightly, but reverently, discreetly, advisedly, and in the fear of God. Into this holy estate, these two persons present come now to be joined. If any man can show just cause why they may not lawfully be joined together, let him now speak, or else hereafter forever keep your mouth closed. I'm looking, and I haven't. Yes. Okay. I require and charge you both, as you will answer at the dreadful day of judgment, when the secrets of all hearts shall be disclosed, that if either of you know any impediment why you may not be lawfully joined together in matrimony, you do now confess it. For be you well assured that if any persons are joined together otherwise than as God's word does allow, their marriage is not lawful. Well, I see Vincent put down his head and said, "Preacher, what are you waiting for?"
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. That's true, sir.
Will you, Vincent Junior Walters, take Antoinette Tiffany Kelly to your wedded wife, to live together after God's ordinance in the holy estate of matrimony? Will you love her, comfort her, and keep her in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, keep thee only unto her, so long as ye both shall live?
I do.
Okay, I was wondering.
I thought you were still going on.
No, no. Thank you. Will you, Antoinette Tiffany Kelly, take Vincent Junior Walters to your wedded husband to live together after God's ordinance in the holy estate of matrimony? Will you obey him and serve him, love, honor, and keep him in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, keep thee only unto him. So long as we both shall live.
I do.
Hallelujah. Who gave this woman to be married to this man?
Thank you, sir.
All right, thank you.
Yes, sir.
Hi, Vincent Jr. Walters.
Hi, Vincent Jr. Walters.
Take. Antoinette Tiffany Kelly.
Antoinette Tiffany Kelly.
To my wedded wife.
To my wedded wife.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
For better, for worse.
For better or for worse.
For richer, for poorer.
For richer or for poorer.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love.
To love.
And to cherish.
And to cherish.
Till death.
Till death.
Us do part.
Us do part.
According to God's holy ordinance.
According to God's holy ordinance.
And thereto.
And thereto.
I give thee my vow.
I give thee my vow.
Let you hold him, Tiffany.
Antoinette.
Hold him. I, Antoinette Tiffany Kelly.
I, Antoinette Tiffany Kelly.
Take.
Vincent.
Junior Walters. To my wedded husband. To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
For better, for worse. For richer, for poorer. In sickness and in health.
To love.
To cherish.
And to obey. And to obey.
Till death do us part. According to God's holy ordinance. And to this. I give thee my vow. Thank you. You may release him forward.
This is the day that we can say